Good morning, grade 3, and a warm welcome to the English class. Well, children, last time I sent you a video on this lesson, correct? What did we do, children? What is this? This is a newspaper article, right? I even showed you some newspapers, I showed you some headlines, right? Remember? The sports section, then the one section was sports, one section was global, one section was nation. Do you remember, children? If you don't, then go back to my previous video. Okay? And see what I have explained. I will ask you in the Zoom. Okay, so this, children, this lesson, we investigated some features of a newspaper report. Right? Now, today, children, we move to the writing section. Newspaper reports, the writing section, that is on page 141. So, here, children, you get an opportunity to write a newspaper report. Wow, you are going to be newspaper reporters. Okay, so now we are going to write an article for a newspaper. And it is based on the three events, children, which we did it in our previous lessons. That is the New Year firework display and eruption of Mount Etna. Then the Tacoma Narrow Bridge disaster. All this we have done. Right? Which lessons are these? I hope you remember, children. Which lessons are these? If you don't remember, you need to open your index and find out. So the first one is Let's Celebrate. Books about bridges, right? So what we will do, children, is we will choose this topic. Last time I told you to do a research, right? I told you to do a research on this topic. I gave you two topics to do research. One was about the volcano and the other was about the Tacoma Bridge. So we will do the Tacoma Bridge disaster. All of us will write the same report. Now, children, before we begin, okay, before you begin your writing, I want to ask you, can you list the features that this newspaper report included? List the features which this newspaper, this is your newspaper article, correct? So what features are displayed here? Think. Headline, correct? What is the headline over here, children? First Sri Lankan climber to reach Everest summit. Then you had the person's name here. What is this called, children? This is a byline. Okay? Then I remember I told you about facts. Facts is something which is truth. Okay? Like this is your fact over here. Children, the day you're born, your birth date, those all remain facts. Okay, facts is which you cannot change. The first person to go on moon. When did India get our independence? These are all facts. Okay. So that's facts. Facts about the event. Okay, so this is your facts about the event. Then what else I told you, children? Yes, background information. Okay, I told you about the background information. Now, what is the background information? What over here, children, what did you have as a background information? See here, they teamed up. Okay, so that would be a background information. I have also written a planning sheet for you. There is a planning sheet. Okay, right, in that also I will tell you later. First, let me just discuss the features quickly with you. Then what are the quotes? Quotes are, children, the direct speech. Okay, the direct speech. This will be our greatest challenge yet. So that was your direct speech. Can you see, children, the commas, inverted commas, speech marks? That's your direct speech. See this. Okay. Then you also had reported quotes. Children, reported quotes are indirect speech. Okay. A colleague in their support team, see this. A colleague in their support team said, so this is your indirect speech. It has no commas, children. This is called as quotes or reported quotes, or they call it as indirect speech. And then finally, we had children, the images, illustration, photographs, images, right? Okay, now what I have done is I have also prepared a planning sheet for you. So you can go through this planning sheet, children, and fill in the information before you begin your report. The planning sheet is a report about a special event. Now, which event, children? We are writing about the bridge. So you could write your name over here. Now, children, remember your headline. It has to be an eye-catching headline. I showed you last time the newspaper. Okay, only if headlines are interesting, children, people would like to read the article. So make it as interesting as you would. Now, there are a few ideas you could write here. I just left one line. So whatever ideas you get, children, about the bridge, you could write that. Then include the name of the reporter. Now, this, children, could be your own name because you are the reporter. Or if you don't want to write your name, you can make up a name. Then remember to write facts. So for this, children, I'd ask you to do research. Okay. So you can't write today's date. Remember that. This is a fact. So you will have to write the day the disaster happened. Okay. Now, children, see your background information. What will you include? This is the events that led up to what you are reporting, and background information about the people involved. So you could give a little background about the bridge, like when it was built or something, like as I told you over here, they teamed up, when did they start? Okay, see, it, the year it is 2016, so when did she start? She started in 2011, so that was a little background information. Then, children, here you will have people whom you will interview there at the site. There are people there. Children, please watch the news. You'll get an idea. Okay, people who were there and saw what happened. So you would give them names and say why they were there. Okay, if you see the news, children, if you see some disaster, recently we had an incident at Uttarakhand. Okay, what happened over there? Flash floods. So then you see how the people, they interview people over there. You can watch it on YouTube, children. It is still there. Then what questions will you ask the people who saw what happened? So you would have to think about your questions so that you could get answers for your report. Now, what illustration, children, would you use? Photograph, maps, or diagrams? Okay, so this is your planning sheet. And also, children, there are some guidelines, okay? I've written that also. Some guidelines are, you should have an appropriate, precise, and catchy headline to capture the reader's attention. This is what I told you. Your headline is very, very important, children. Okay? So then the next one is, state only facts. Children, only facts. And remember always to be written a report. Writing, we write in a third person. So use of pronouns like I, me, you should be avoided. Should be avoided. Then always, children, you know, we have done pronoun, no? First person, second person, third person. I, we, these are all first person pronouns. Pronouns is what? Which is used instead of a noun. Instead of every time I saying Sia, Sia, so I'll say she. Instead of every time saying, taking my name, I say I. So that's a pronoun. They. Those are all pronouns. Now, always be written in indirect speech or reported speech. Okay, that's how you write your report. And you will have details of the place and date. And you need to have all the relevant information. Children, that's why I told you to do a research on this topic. Okay, so remember the steps to be followed, children, for newspaper writing. Okay, you will have your heading, name of the reporter, place, date, beginning of the report, which will give you details regarding of when and what, like this. See, right at the beginning of the report. And then you will also conclude. Okay, conclude means when you end your, and you will have facts. Okay, so remember that. And when you conclude, children, remember to even have your eyewitness. Like here she has taken her friends. Like children, for a building collapse or a bridge collapse, you will have people over there because people are staying around there, no? So, or passerbys. So, you could have that. And yes, one more very important thing, children, is you know, when these disasters happen, a natural disaster, like say a bridge collapse, or you could say a building, if a building collapse, then the government gives some compensation. Okay, so you could include that, like the government has decided to give every, like when a person dies, they get in some money. Compensation is money, what the government gives it. So you could mention that. If you research, maybe you will find out what was the compensation given to the people at that time. Find out if it is. Right? So, what's your homework, children? Your homework is this newspaper report. You're going to write a newspaper report. Children, remember we are writing the third one. Okay? These are all the units. It's given over here. Which are the units? Unit 6, Unit 14 and Unit 10. So, we are writing on Unit 10, that is books about bridges, the Tacoma Narrows Bridge Disaster. So, read this, children. They have given you headlines, what is a byline, what are facts, what are background information, eyewitness accounts and illustrations. Read this, then go through the planning sheet what I gave you and go through even the guidelines which I have given you. I will post that in the WhatsApp group. So that's all, children. I think we have come to the end of our portion. Yes. So maybe we'll discuss in Zoom, right? So good luck, reporters, all newspaper reporters, good luck. See you, children, in the Zoom. Happy learning.